land is a vital source of income, and it provides shelter. In Southeast Europe, agriculture plays an important role in economy by being one of the three main sectors and counting on average 11.45% of GDP. Women who work and live in rural areas are also considerable in numbers. Almost half of the rural population is women, and they count up to 48% of the total working force. Although they are contributing family workers in agricultural activities, FAO asserted that women face obstacles when it comes to control and use of the necessary extension services, agricultural inputs, technology, and land. A joint FAO and World Bank study shows that the average number of female landowners or co-owners in Southeast Europe varies from 15 to 39% nationally. Studies have shown that co-ownership of land increases the likelihood of women to own independent bank accounts. A global study found that stronger property rights were associated with an increased average annual growth of per capita income by 6 to 14 percentage points.
Good morning.
Hello, welcome back. Did you finally reach an agreement on the land you were talking about?
Yes, we have an agreement. Let us make it legal.
Okay, good. Before we start, I need some information from your side. Are you married? How did you gain the property that you were selling? Did you gain it through an exchange, division, legalization, or privatization? Was it a gift? Did you inherit it? Did you buy it? Were you married when you gained it? Do you have the family certificate from the time when you gained the property? Your wife must be present in order to complete the transaction. Where is she? Does she know that you are selling a property?
All properties gained during marriage through sale contracts, legalization, exchange, or division of property and privatization belong to both spouses in equal shares. As a result, both should approve any transactions that happen with them. If a property is inherited or obtained as a gift, it is considered personal property. If it is purchased by a married person, it becomes property of both spouses in equal shares. Register with your partner as co-owners before it is too late, because you might need to go to court to sign co-ownership. You might need to pay a high notary fee. You might go through exhausting bureaucracy at the registration desk. The spouse whose name is missing cannot take a loan and open a business. Southeast Europe shares similar history and culture, but also similar legal systems and laws. The law guarantees gender equality to a certain extent, but reality is different. There are rural areas where the percentage of women who own property is as low as 3%. GIZ, on behalf of the German Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development, in cooperation with Food and Agriculture Organization, have been coordinating their efforts in Southeast European countries to promote progress on Sustainable Development Goal number 5 on gender equality. The project will provide a regional exchange of best practices on gender-sensitive enforcement of property rights by facilitating legal drafting, drafting and implementation of guidelines for notaries and registration offices, creating regional expert forums, trainings, and creating other forms of exchange platforms on gender and land tenure.